And people ask me this kind of stuff all the time. Yeah. What do I do? How do I sleep better? How do I stop stressing? And usually I find that people are not serious, meaning they want an answer, but they don't want to do the work.
Right. Yeah.
So I was like, look, it's really simple. Can you not eat until 2 p.m.? I was like, yeah, I'm not hungry in the morning. I'm like, great. Drink coffee, drink water, and in the morning get up and just get on, either run or get on some exercise bike and just pedal like someone's chasing you with a syringe full of poison.
Right in the morning after when you wake up.
Yeah, or, you know, after a few minutes. Okay. You know, give yourself some time. Go to the bathroom. I mean,
you're serious. I have questions about this.
Early
because
day.
I'm the opposite, right? I find it hard for me to gain weight and stuff like that. So please continue, though. I got this question after.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I mean, and the reason I felt any... sense of agency in giving this information is, I've done a bunch of different things in neuroscience related to vision and neuroplasticity and stress, but I've done some work and continue to do some work with special operations and some of these groups that are interested in how you use biology to improve human performance mm-hmm. over long periods of time.
Okay.
So, basketball players, military, these kinds of things. And so there's a pretty straightforward formula where when you've been asleep all night, your fuel reserves, like you've got fuel in your fat. You guys don't have any of that. But you got fuel in your fat, you've got fuel in your muscles that can be burned, and you got fuel in your liver. It's called glycogen. And when you wake up early, all of that is as low as it's going to be because you haven't been eating anything.
Gotcha.
And so if you exercise then, your body starts dropping into your body fat stores quicker. So what I was trying to give Mike was a tool that would allow him to see some results really quickly. So I said, look, do it fasted, and then continue to hydrate, and then eat your first meal in the afternoon. And I said, and also, do you like drinking? And he was like, well, I don't know. I drink mostly because it kind of sets me straight up here. And I was like, well, we can talk about the stuff to kind of set your head level. I mean, he wasn't spun out. He just obviously was medicating with alcohol.
Sure.
And not in a severe way because he's fully functional. He's an amazing photographer. Yeah. He has two kids. Yeah. And so I want to be clear about what we're talking about here.
Yeah.
I didn't detect anything dysfunctional about him. He was just reporting to me that he wanted some assistance.
Right.
So I said, would you be willing to drop the drinking or pare it back? Yeah. And he said, sure. So, okay. So explain that. And I said, look, and here's my number just, for the anxiety and stress management, I'll give you some respiration tools that work really well mm-hmm. that are not, woo mysticism. Yeah. I'm not going to tell you to meditate 30 minutes a day, although that's a cool practice too. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you some tools you can use in real time as you're working hard and dealing with whatever it is you're dealing with in life. Okay. So that ends. The conversation ends, and Greg Hunt was there too. Okay. I knew from growing up.
Yeah.
Talked to Greg a little bit. And then a year later, Mike reaches out and says, hey man, thanks for all that stuff you gave me. I was like, oh, cool. And he's like, I lost 60 pounds and I haven't had a sip of alcohol since we talked last and feeling pretty good.
Damn.
And I was like, so how did you do it? He's like, well, I get on the bike and I pedal as hard as I can. And like someone chasing me with a syringe full of poison.
Sure.
And I was like, he remembered. Yeah. And I was so impressed. Like very few people can just take the menu and just do it.
Go.
Right?
Right.
And maybe it's his Midwest upbringing. Mm-hmm. I mean, he did get gifted a AK rifle for his 9th birthday living in Ohio growing up. I mean, Mike's. Okay. Yeah.
But some people also, I feel like, reach that point in their life where they're like, it's time. Whether it's smoking or drinking, like you can't quit smoking unless you're mentally prepared to, right? It's like, there's that switch.
Look, I always say, the beauty of being young is that neuroplasticity, your nervous system's ability to change in response to experience, to learn things, is at its absolute peak. Mm-hmm. However, you don't have that much control over your life when you're young,
right?
Especially when you're really young. As you get older, it gets harder to change your nervous system, but you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
But the advantage you have is that you can direct exactly what changes you want to happen. Mm. And so there are two different ways to change your nervous system depending on whether or not you're younger or you're older. And it's not like the gate drops right at 25.
Okay.
It just tapers off. But Mike made the decision, and I always say if somebody is an adult, you can't change their mind.
Right.
You literally can't. They have to make the decision to do that.